Direction le Misba, un petit restaurant de Jérusalem-Est. J'y ai rendez-vous avec Abou Hassan, un guide touristique palestinien engagé, puisqu'il cherche à sensibiliser ses clients à la cause palestinienne en les emmenant autour du mur de séparation ou encore dans des camps de réfugiés.
Okay, so my name is Abou Hassan. You know, I'm running, you know, the alternative tours since 12 years to explain the people what's going on in our countries and what's happening here, the facts, what's going on in the ground.
Chapitre 1, les Palestiniens.
To born in Jerusalem, something very special. You know, it's a very nice city, and but in the same time, it's very hard and difficult. You know what I mean? Because of the occupation, mainly, actually. For example, you know what I mean? Of how the Israeli demolishing houses, how the Israeli not giving us a permission to build houses in Jerusalem, how the checkpoint around Jerusalem, you know what I mean? The freedom of movement, you know, is very difficult. You know what I mean? All these things, you know, make our life disaster. Because every day we have to think, you know, if for example, if I want to go tomorrow to see my friend somewhere, another way I have to think if there will be checkpoint open or it's closed or allowed me to go through or not allowed me to go through. You never know. And this is, it makes you very tired as a human. You know, almost every family you go, you know what I mean, they miss somebody. You know what I mean, killed or arrested or injured. I growing up in Jerusalem and now I'm 44 years old. You know, till now I don't see any kind of peace in my life. You know, all the time when I growing up till now I see all this fight and all that things and somehow we are tired.
Chapitre 2, les Palestiniens, peace.
First thing, I don't think of divisions between Muslims and Christians. You know, I mean, I think we are one people, one unity. You know, of course you will find fanatic in any religion, some people, but it's not the majority, it's not that feel. So we have no divisions between Muslims and Christians. We are all Palestinian, you know what I mean? And we are all struggling for the same reason, is end of occupation. You know, it's this is our population as every population in the world. You know, we have secular Palestinians, we have religious, we have fanatic, we have like every population in this world. You know what I mean? Of course, the religious, they have their part. I mean, it's not bother me. You know, they will be bother me if they're interfering my way of living. Actually, I don't feel that they're interfering. I'm drinking. You know, they have a lot of international interfering into our issue. You know, it make us divided in this way we are now. You know, and especially after the elections we have in 2006, where it's a fact. You know what I mean? That Hamas, you know, it's part of our population here, and nobody can denying that. And the fact is, Hamas win the election by fair and clean, by witness with international witnesses. But what not fair, how the world are react against our election, you know, by putting international sage, you know, against our people, not just against Hamas. And for us, it's painful, you know, to see what's going on now in Palestine, especially between Palestinians. You know what I mean? Like we talk about two states now, Gaza and West Bank, you know, and where this is, in the winning of that is the Israelis, and this is exactly what they want. And they've been trying for the last 40 years, you know, this to separating Gaza and from West Bank, but they're not been succeed, you know what I mean? So now we, for the last 2 years, we give them as a gift. No, but not because of us. As I said, that's what I explained to you. They have a lot of the international pressure for this. You know, so we hope that the international, you know, I mean, that to understand one day, you know, doesn't matter how things go through here, it will not be end, you know, without to establishing an, you know, Palestinian state, you know what I mean, and to giving the right of the Palestinian people to establishing their freedom, establishing their state in their own home, in the homeland. You know what I mean? Together next to Israel, the state, you know, but injustice. You know what I mean? Not anywhere how the Israel now they are trying to do it by putting the separation wall, you know, by putting the checkpoint, by dividing our territories. This is not, they were not winning with this. We are here, you know, and we will still here, and we will still struggle, you know, till you know what I mean, the international to understand, you know, that the peace in this world, it's come from here. You know, without just a solution for Jerusalem, for good peace in this world, not just in this region. Because Jerusalem is the key of the peace in this world.
Chapitre 3, les Israéliens.
Deep, I cannot tell you, know, so much because I don't have so much communication with them, but I read what I see. You know, Israeli society, it's actually more divided than us. You know, because it's Israeli society divided in two parts. You know, where Jews come from Western countries and Jews come from Eastern and Arab states. So where even between them, you know what I mean, they have no equality. Because the Western Jews come from the United States or come from West Europe, from France, Germany, Britain. They are the one, you know, actually they run, you know, and they have the power in that state. You know, and they want to force it to establishing a state in Middle East as Western state. And this is not able to work. You know, they can try, but it will never work. You know, because we are in the Eastern countries. We are in an Eastern place. We are in Eastern land. I mean, as I said to you, for example, look to the Yemenese Jews from Yemen. They have the quarters in Tel Aviv. You know, go on to see by yourself how they live. You know, they are better. They are not living better than us. You know, they have no right. If you the way they're living like refugees. You know. And actually, many of them, you know, during the beginning of the Intifada, to try to, then some of the family, they come into Ramallah, into Kumukata, to Arafat, in that time, 2002, if I remember, there's about 30 family of them, and they try to come and to have Palestinian citizen. And they've been staying in Mukata for 2 weeks, and they're asking Arafat to have the citizen of Palestine. You know, in that time, there was a lot of pressure in the Palestinian Authority to not give them and to move away from there, you know, American pressure. So to see, it's if you're going and see between the two, into the separation between them, believe me, they're hating each other more than anybody else hates them. Look, show me one, an Israeli president, he been come from Arab state, for example.
Chapitre 4, les Palestiniens et les Israéliens.
You see, something just to explain you that us and the Jews, we have no problems. We are not against Jewish. We've been lived together. You know, Arabs and Jews have been living together. But since the Zionists, you know, moving to Palestine, especially after the Second World War, this is where the problem is starting. You know, our problem not with the Jews, our problem with the Zionists. I've never been anti-Jewish. Jewish for me is a religion. And I accept the Jewish religion. I'm not religious person, but I'm accepted as a Jewish religion.
Chapitre 5, l'avenir.
See, as I said to you, what I want to see in my life here, you know, that even the last day, I want to see end of occupation. I don't want to see Israeli soldiers in my land. I want to see a better future. I want to see my freedom. I want to, when I go to France, I want to go anywhere else, I want to carry my passport as a Palestinian. This is what I want to see. I don't want to see anything else. This is the main goal of me. You know, I want to see this occupation end. And I hope it will be soon.